Between 1537 and 1540, Henry VIII instigated a campaign to build a chain of defences along the south coast to counter the threat from the combined forces of France and Spain. Three artillery fortifications at Dover were to provide protection for the newly constructed harbour. One of these, Moat's Bulwark, was situated at the foot of the cliff beneath Dover Castle, because the guns at Dover Castle were unable to elevate sufficiently to defend the harbour. Around the 1750s, it was modified into a large semicircular battery, with many other alterations. In 1856, it was linked with Dover Castle by a spiral staircase, tunnelled into the cliff behind. Moat's Bulwark is the only remaining example of the three batteries known to have been built Dover during this period. And as a small battery rather than a fort, it represents a particularly rare survival.
Never actually filmed this before, so this is a first, folks. It's been in being in your town, it's like you're taking a lot of things for granted. So this is like Henry VIII's castle in Dover, so this is, you know, Dover's second castle basically, folks. So let's check it out.
So where are we going in here?
Going straight up, mate.
I was just saying, watch out for needles.
Yeah. It's a hot place for needles, folks. So zigzag stairs take you all the way up. Mad, isn't it?
It does look pretty good from down on there. As you're up on the road,
so that down there, that circular part, that that's a battery, a gun battery. And this takes you up to the final stretch.
Here's where it's going to get interesting, guys.
Yeah, we'll certainly see, won't we?
Look at the view.
And there you go.
Looks a little clean, doesn't it?
It does. This is a fantastic piece of history, this is. It's like, look at the brickwork. It's all, like, in the mortar, you got, like, bits of flint. This is crazy piece of history. I don't know why, if English Heritage only, I don't know why it's been left like this. I really don't. It's like a place for druggies and people drinking and stuff, folks. It's such a shock. I really don't know what's been going on here. What do you reckon, Ben?
Yeah, point.
You reckon it's a big shock, though, isn't it, really?
Yeah, it's good. I didn't go down there last time. It's a big old drop, isn't it?
It is, yeah. I should have said beforehand, watch yourself.
Oh, the old chimney
there. The chimney and that. It's such a big shame, though. It's like it's been abused, basically. I don't know who owns it, though. I don't know if it's English Heritage that own it or what, or the council own it. But this is Dover's second castle. Dover's got two castles. But if I'm going to put it out there, Dover's got three castles.
Where's the third one?
I'll show you one day. So I'll keep it on that. Now another, do you know what these are, Ben?
No, put a machine gun on it.
Spigot mortar, they're like grenade launchers. So that's facing out over
grenade
the
grenade launchers,
eh? Like a, it's a spigot mortar.
Spigot mortar.
Spigot. A spigot mortar. So it's like a a projectile that's pushed like a grenade launcher.
Oh, right.
At the enemy. It's mad.
I didn't mean they had grenade launchers back in the old days.
Yeah, folks. An asteroid would have been on that. It would have been like a thing with two handles. Like you move it about. The flints in the mortar. It's lovely. This down here looks, you can see, hey, you see that, Ben? You can actually see the turrets on the top of that. It's in the ivy, but you can see the castle turrets, look.
Yeah, the old turrets, yeah.
Yeah, whatever they're called. That's mad.
Good, isn't it?
It is, yeah. That's not as old, though.
I didn't see them last time, either.
That's not as old, though, that, as the one behind us. See the wood? Look at the size of that wood.
You might have that in your garden, wouldn't you? Well, I'd bet wood like that. And then you've got the stone.
And there's the old chimney. That's probably a later addition as well. I'm not sure. Not sure, folks. But it's all this stuff that's been going on here. It's needles and... There's all sorts. There's another needle cap there. Ah, oh, so bad. It needs to be sorted, this does. It really does. And that you've got the position there looking out over the... There's a needle there. Just seen one, folks. Really got to watch where you're standing. There you go. Have a close-up. That's another one behind that can there, look. Shocking, folks.
Oh,
bad, mate, isn't it? Bad.
I get worried, mate. As soon as you like think about that needles, you're like worried. Oh, I stood on one.
Right, put your shoes on, lad. It's just one thing that really scares me is needles. But on the positive side, there, I don't. You know, I'm just putting it out there. The AIDS and that stuff dies out the body, so the AIDS being on those needles is very low.
Oh yeah. What,
but I don't know about hepatitis, so.
Depends how long they've been there and all that.
Yeah. Crazy, man. It's not right, mate, no. Needs cleaning. Yeah, it's quite high down there. I was going to have a wander, but I don't think I will. Right, so if you head over into that corner over there, there's something over there you might want to see. The zigzag path up to there, you can see the battery from here, quite clear. I know what's under that, a mattress, isn't it? Do you remember?
Keeping it dry.
Yeah. There is Sally Port that takes you up to the top of the castle. 1800s, I think. If you would like to see in there, inside here, folks, it's locked today, but if you want to see in here...
What day is it open?
Hey?
What day is it open?
Well, it was open years ago.
So this is the entrance to the castle, I take it?
Yes, this
one
is...
Of the
That was like a guard room, I think that part was in there. It did have like the castle bits at the top there, if you can see. But they've rotted away, sadly. But yeah, it's a Sally Port. It's not from the Henry VIII's time, but it's still a piece of amazing history from Dover Castle. Obviously, as you can see, folks, people have been trying to breach it and stuff, and it's been patched, so. I mean, this must have been a little guard room here. Must have been. I love that though. I've got to watch where he's standing, that's the only trouble.
It does look pretty small, doesn't it?
Yeah. Another tent there, folks. So yes, whoever owns this needs a major clear up, basically. Because people interested in history come up here and stuff like that, and there's needles up here. There's heroin use up here. And it's absolutely filthy. As we've seen in those needles, if youngsters come up here, as they do, because, you know, when I was little, I used to come up here and playing and stuff and, you know, and exploring. And then there's needles up here, you know, and all it takes is one little prick and then you've done it, haven't you? So, it's shocking. Dover needs to do something about this. They need to do it now. Let's get it out there, folks. Share this video. Let's go. Part way up the cliff, we've got a wall here, flint, made out of flint and sandstone, it looks like. Yeah, that's been there a while. I think it's just holding up the cliff, to be honest. Yeah, so that's one of the entrances. It's the doorways, aren't it? You see, sort of window, is it? It's an actual brick doorway, and there's another one further up. Look at the brickwork. You can see it's deep, it's been dug deep into the chalk. You see the chalk there, the cliff goes out there, and the doorway's here. But yeah, well and truly sealed, folks. English Heritage owned this lot in here.
Really?
Yeah. So it's like, you'd probably be able to get a trip through them if you asked them. Friends of Dover Castle and all that, folks, probably. That's probably the only way, really, you're going to get to see inside there with your own eyes. Sure, it's a support wall. But look at the brickwork, look at the way it's been made. The brickwork, the way it's, well, the bricks. Look at the flintwork.
Someone spent many hours putting the old flintwork up here.
Yeah, it's truly, and they've got the sandstone, and is that sandstone or chalk?
Yeah.
It's sandstone, isn't it? Yeah. It's lovely, though. Hidden in the trees.
Oh, no.
What was that? Is that your phone? What?
Watch right, there you go, guys. A bit of rough and tumble for you there.
Whoa.
Oh, needle.
Serious note though, folks, serious note that it's dangerous up here, obviously, with the needles and stuff like that. Until this gets in the Dover Express or something, the Dover people and the owners need to know about it. It's filthy. And also, you've got that other building down there. So. Look at the brickwork down there. Look at the brickwork there. Watch where he's standing around here. That's caps there. Blue caps, yeah. I've only seen orange caps previous.
What's that?
I don't know what that is. But they're heroin spoons,
yeah.
Aren't they? They gotta be, aren't they? They are.
Yeah, the old burnt bottoms, isn't it?
Yeah, but they're not spoons, they're like something that they probably get from the health centre.
Yeah, but why? How?
I know. Look, it's a box, it's got some bits in it. What's in there? This is like another room here, isn't it? And the thing I've just noticed, the wall at the back there, is actually made of chalk.
It is chalk, isn't it? Or is that sandstone? It's hard to tell.
Yeah. So up here is a bit mix and match as well. A bit of flint, a bit of sandstone, a bit of chalk.
I wonder how old those big joists are at the top there.
They're doing alright though, aren't they?
They are, if they're original.
So then, this one's doing alright up here. But that one there is doing a bit.
That bit with a reinforced bar in the middle, that's not Henry VIII. I don't think his engineers did reinforcing. So yeah, if you know any information on that, folks, that's interesting. I know, it wasn't, this is recent really, this is like the last couple of years, all this graffiti and folks. I hope it don't fall down. Hopefully, if when this video gets out there, folks, Dover Council or English Heritage are actually do something about it, because this is it's shocking. This is like 1500s. As you got the famous White Cliffs, Dover Castle up there. And we've got these massive blocks that have obviously fallen from somewhere.
Yeah, imagine that you being there at that time.
Yeah. And no, more to the point, folk, over here. Imagine being right here when that fell down. That was on the cliff, I'd say, up there.
I think, yeah.
So that's been rolled off, or it's fallen in time?
I didn't think that. I saw it there earlier on. I said about it. And
that's like a couple of ton.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah, that's heavy.
There could be someone under it. You know, who knows?
Boom.
Boom, indeed.
Imagine that.
But that made a...
Imagine you stand there. Like, say for instance, like, we were just standing there, and...
That just happened?
This block or something just fell off.
Yeah.
What would you do? You'd be like, Jesus.
Be a pancake.
I've witnessed that. It's like the saying. If a tree falls down in the forest, does it make noise?
So I'm not sure on his intentions. I think this was like a second defence for the castle. Henry VIII. All the information will be in the description as well. Look at that over there, it looks like someone's cut something in the chalk. Like a hole. It's a mystery. So this is a part of the original battery right down here. It's actually got a moat right around it. You see the brickwork there, the one on the outer, the really small bricks, they're old. Really old. It's probably part of the original 1500s one, Henry VIII's. And then you got like the Napoleonic ones, I'd say, possibly, folks, here. The red bricks. But yeah, we're inside the battery part at the moment. I think it's Guildford Battery. Gah! Them things there, I'm sure they're, you can't really see them, folks, but expense magazines. They're probably Victorian, or yeah, they're probably Victorian actually. So early 1900s for the battery. So yeah, you see it's been adopted so many times. It's getting dark, it's crazy. And if you look over the edge there, the moat.
It's actually brick moat. Goes all the way around. You see the ditch, original ditch. Can't see it on the other side there. But over there, you can see the ditch. Remember taking this, folks. It's lowered here. This is probably where it was lowered, say, in the late 1800s, early 1900s, for allowing artillery fire over it, possibly something like that. Then you've got the original, this is the outer wall of the battery. I think it's Guildford Battery, I'm sure it is. Look at this. Hey? There's been a cut here at some point. It's been breached. This is probably Second World War, I'd say, something like that, folks. You can see where the damage to the work here, the brickwork. I really hope it wasn't Dover District Council. You know what they're like. They've destroyed more buildings in Dover, the Dover District Council, than the Germans did in the Second World War. Crazy, that is true. It seems like it, doesn't it?
Yeah. Especially if they're destroying this. Well, it's not destroying, it's old, isn't it?
See the brickwork here?
Yeah, that's right.
Goes up like a slant up the cliff there. That's all to stop it sliding down, I suppose, because it's quite a, it's like a bank. I don't know if all that was put up there, like, to create the fortification, I don't know.
As this being a rare surviving example, you would think that more care would have been taken to preserve it. It's neglected. The owners should be ashamed. The future of this historic piece is unknown.